method we are going to discuss the graphical method of solving a linear programming problem. Of course, once the LPP, we have seen how to formulate an LPP. So once the LPP is formulated on the basis of given objective and the constraint function, then the next step is naturally to obtain the optimal solution. Now there are various methods of solving an LPP. One of them is the graphical method. As I said, in three or more dimensions, it is difficult to draw the graph, but in two dimensions, between two variables, it can be easily drawn. So it is easy to solve an LPP by graphical method in two dimensional steps. The steps are as follows. If the problem is not formulated, then formulate the LPP. Mathematically, that means expressing the constraint as well as the objective function using some mathematical function. The objective function relates to the optimization aspect, that is maximization or minimization criteria. Now we have to plot each of the constraint. Please remember that when we are talking about the optimum solution, the first step is naturally to obtain the solution, and we have already seen the definition of optimum solution. Solution means the decision variables which satisfy the constraint. And when we talk about feasible solution, then the solution which also satisfy non-negativity constraint. So the first task is to obtain feasible solution, because we have seen in the theorem that the optimum solution of the given problem will lie at the extreme point of the set K, where set K is a feasible solution set of all feasible solution to the problem. In other words, the first step is to obtain feasible solution. Now to obtain the feasible solution, we need to obtain a solution, and that means the decision variables which satisfy the constraint. And therefore, in this method also, we have to plot first the constraint. Now how to plot the constraint graphically? Each inequality, if the inequalities are there in the constraint, then each inequality, whether it is less than equal to or greater than equal to, in the constraint equation has to be treated as an equation. Even if the inequality is there, to draw the constraint, we will consider that inequality as the equation. For example, suppose the constraint is like this, x1 plus x2 less than equal to 6. So we will consider it as x1 plus x2 equal to 6. Now to draw the constraint, we will put or assign arbitrary value to first variable. So the first variable here is x1. So we will assign any arbitrary value to x1, and using that we will find the value of x2. Generally, arbitrary value means the 0 is assigned. So if I put x1 equal to 0, you will get x2 equal to 6. That means the point now is 0, 6, right? Similarly, in the second step, we will assign arbitrary value to this particular variable, and we will obtain the value of the first variable. Again, if I put x2 equal to 0, naturally you will get x1 equal to 6. So the now point becomes 6, 0. So in the first step, or in this particular step, we got a point at 0, 6, and in this particular step, we got a point 6, 0. So that is basically the two points. To plot the constraint, we will need, or to draw the line segment, we will need two points, and those two points are obtained using this particular method. So the now points are 60 and 06, and we will join that particular point, right? Now please remember that the constraint was x1 plus x2 less than equal to 6 and not x1 plus x2 equal to 6. So we will see how to basically consider this constraint after drawing the constraint line or line segment. In this fashion, we are going to draw each and every constraint. Okay, so the two set of values are plotted on the graph, as I just said to you, connected by straight line. The same procedure has to be repeated all the for all the constraints. So it means that if there exist three constraints, three line segments will be there. If there are two constraints, two line segments will be there. Now solution will be the decision variable which satisfy all the constraints. So remember these statements also while drawing the constraint lines. Hence the total straight lines would be equal to the total number of equation, each straight line representing one constraint equation. Now what is going to be the solution? So the next step is to locate the solution space. Now as I said, the solution space should satisfy all the constraint, right? So when you draw all the line segment, you will have some common region, right? That common region is nothing but your solution space. So solution space or the feasible region is the graphical area which satisfy all the constraint at the same time. Such a solution point xy always occur at the corner points of the feasible solution. Now how to determine that feasible region is determined as follows. Now as I told you, the original in our example, the constraint was x1 plus x2 less than equal to 6, but we have considered or we have treated that as equation x1 plus x2 equal to c equal to 6 to draw the constraint line. Once you draw the constraint line, if you remember the definition of hyperplane, hyperplane will always divide the space into two parts, right? So which part, that means the close part or open part, but we have discussed that definition, but which part? So once you draw the particular line, which region you should consider, whether the region lying above that particular line or region which is lying below that particular point. So that is basically explained here. For greater than or greater than equal to constraint, the feasible region or the solution space is the area that lies above the constraint line, right? Whereas for less than or less than equal to constraint, the feasible region or the solution space is the area that lies below the constraint line. In other words, in the example which we have discussed, x1 plus x2 less than equal to 6, so once you draw the constraint line, then you will have two region, one region lying below the line and another region which is lying above that particular line. So according to this particular statement, we will consider the region which is lying below that particular constraint line, right? So that is basically the meaning of this particular statement. So in this fashion, we are going to draw and we are going to consider all the region. Once all the region has been identified, that means whether you are going to consider the region lying below that line or region lying above the line, you will have a region which is common to all the constraint, right? Since the solution, now we have seen the theorem also, that theorem tells us that the optimum solution of the given problem is going to lie at the extreme point of that particular set, that is K. According to that theorem, here also the feasible solution will have some, or that solution space will also have some extreme points. So in this case, we will consider extreme point matlab vertices or the corner points. So our solution is going to belong to these particular points. So extreme points वहाँ पे भी होंगे. Extreme point का मतलब in this case will be a corner points. So therefore, that is what I have written here. Since the solution point xy always occur at the corner points of the feasible solution or space, identify each of the extreme points or the corner points of the feasible region. Now by putting the coordinates of the corner points in the objective function, that means once you identify the extreme point or corner point, use those corner points put those corner points in your objective function. Objective function is also there, which is also expressed in terms of x1 and x2. So put those values of x1 and x2 into the objective function. You will have different values for different corner points, right? So if there are four corner points, you will have four different values of that particular objective function. So compute the value at each of the corner points. So if the problem is about maximization problem, then the optimum solution occur at that corner point, which gives you maximum value. So as I said, if there exist four corner points, we will put these four corner points in the objective function. You will have four different values of the objective function. So if the problem is about maximization problem, out of those four points, one value, which is the maximum value, is your optimum value of the objective function. And the value which is maximum, which is occurring at certain corner point, that corner point is nothing but your optimum solution to the given problem. Similarly, agar problem minimization ka hai, then according to this particular statement, again, out of those four values, the minimum value where it is basically occurring, that particular point will give you the optimum solution, and that value, which is minimum value, is nothing but your optimum solution. So depending upon whether the problem is minimization or maximization, you will consider the minimum value of the objective value, objective function, or maximum value of the objective function respectively. So in this fashion, we can obtain the, or we can solve the graphical, we can solve the LPP using graphical method.